Hi, my name is Lila Malone, and this is my favorite song project presentation. So the song I chose for this project is The Devil Wears a Suit and Tie by Coulter Wall. Here's the song.
Well, Reverend, Reverend, please come quick, 'cause I got something to admit. I met a man out in the stakes, a good old miss. He drove a series tank, had a black and more cigar on his lip. Don't you know the devil wears a suit and tie? Saw him driving down the 61 in early July, white as a cotton, feeling sharp as a knife. I heard him howling as he passed me by. And he said, I know you, young man. I know you by the state of your hands. You're a six-string picker, just as I am. Let me learn you some of those few turns to make all the girls dance. Don't you know my daddy wears a suit and tie? I saw him driving down the 61 in early July, white as a cotton, feeling sharp as a knife. I heard him howling as he passed me by. Damn my foolish eyes. 'Cause that man's lessons had a price, oh sweet price. My sweet soul, everlasting, my very own eternal life. Don't you know that the devil wears a suit and tie? I saw him driving down the 61 in early July, white as a cotton, feeling sharp as a knife. I heard him howling as he passed me by. Well, the devil wears a suit and tie. I saw him driving down the 61 in early July, white as a cotton, feeling sharp as a knife. I heard him howling as he passed me by.
So the target audience appears to be country fans and or singer-songwriter fans, as it is clearly a country song. It is a more traditional, stripped-down version of country compared to the country we hear on the radio nowadays, so I think it might also appeal to an older audience or people who are interested in like a stripped country revival. It also has a blues vibe to it, so it might appeal to that audience as well. The song came out in 2017, so there has not been enough time for the audience to adapt and change. The song plays the role of visual storytelling. So I think if a person closes their eyes and listens to this song, they can see what's going on. And I think that's really, really important and well done in this case. They can kind of create their own vision and understand the story from their own perspective. So the song is split up into three verses and three choruses, with a fourth chorus repeating at the end. There is no specific bridge because there's nothing different enough, as the verses all follow a similar pattern. So there's nothing that is, like I said, different enough to be its own thing and be titled a bridge. So verse one is the intro to the story. The man, the character, is telling the reverend of his church about a man he met. And in verse 2, he's telling the reverend of this specific encounter he had when talking to him. And in verse 3, he explains that the man cursed him with eternal life. The chorus repeats three times, and a fourth time at the end. And it's split into verse, chorus, verse, chorus, verse, chorus, chorus. The chorus goes, "Don't you know that the devil wears a suit and tie?" Implying that it is a modern interpretation of the devil instead of a biblical interpretation. I saw him driving down the 61 early July. 61 is a highway, I believe, somewhere in Canada, as Colter Wall is a Canadian country artist. And he said he was white as a cotton field and sharp as a knife, that kind of mysterious aesthetic, and I heard him howling as he passed me by, displaying that kind of otherworldly, like I said, aesthetic to this man that is very mysterious and suspicious. How they work together is that they tell a linear story. There is a clear beginning, middle, and end to this story. It's told strictly from the character's point of view. He's explaining what happened to the reverend, and it is his perspective only, and he has his own interpretation of the story that he is explaining to the reverend and to the listener. What I thought was interesting to note was that the song addresses the topic of non-traditional music, meaning like not classical music and not, I don't know, stereotypical music of the time in the like early 1900s, like 20s, 30s, 40s, being associated with evil, as how blues and country and rock and roll could be associated with the devil by some religious views or people in specifically Christianity and Catholicism at that time. So I thought that was interesting because the man said, "You are a six-string picker," meaning he's a guitar player just as I am, and how he calls him the devil, and that the devil is a guitar player. So I thought that was interesting. The music is fits the same mysterious and suspicious vibe of the lyrics. It is in the key F minor. No, it is not. My apologies. It's in the key F sharp minor, and minor chords are associated with more negative emotions like sadness, anger, and fear. And I think that adds to the mysterious, uneasy aesthetic that the song has. Like I said earlier, it's also very stripped down, so it adds that kind of vintage feel that may appeal to older country fans or blues fans. And Colter Wall uses tempo along with crescendo and decrescendo to emphasize importance and suspense. So in the third verse, the tempo slows way down to emphasize difference and that you should be paying attention. And he explains that he has been cursed with eternal life. He also uses a decrescendo there. The music gets quieter, so you have to pay more attention to it. And then going into the next chorus, it crescendos back up and speeds back up, emphasizing the more like intense, hardcore part of the song. So the whole song works together to make this very mysterious story that is, in my opinion, very interesting. So, in my opinion, the story is not one that tries to convey or invoke emotion. I think it's more the guitar playing and the music that invokes emotion. Because the guitar playing is obviously very beautiful and very well done. Coulter Wall is a very talented guitar player. I think that is what invokes emotion rather than the story. The story is very good, but I don't think it would make anyone feel like a specific emotion, like sadness or anger or happiness in general. It's more just like something to go along with the music that is conveying the emotion. Thank you.